Hello there and welcome to this new video. Most of us, we love to use the internet and to be able to use a phone. And when it comes to the bills, well, we'd all like to bring them to be cheaper, don't we? In today's video, I'm going to show to you my tried and tested method to see how you can manage to get a lower bill or more features for the same bill. So, follow me in this video. Before we get into the 5 steps that you need to take to be able to get where you want to be with your bill, first we'll look at a base that you need to establish. And there are 2 parts to this base. Well, this is a must. You need to have the reputation that you pay your bills, and that will help you to build a solid record as a valued and a valuable customer to the company. You need to be patient. Your contract may have a 1 year or a 2 years terms or an 18 month term, and what you need to do is you need to wait until the last 2 months that are on your contract to be able to take some action. And when you get there, then you will need to prepare. So now we come to our 5 steps. Let's go to step number 1. You need to shop around, look at the competition and find offers that you may actually be interested in and take note of these. And that will get you leverage later on when you'll be talking with your own company, and that will help them to understand that you mean business and that you could really go as a customer. Step number 2. Now, what you need to do is take a hard look at the current offers that your provider currently has. Because when they will call you, they will try to offer you these offers and making you think that they were designed especially for you when they are actually offers that they are making at the moment. So make sure you know that and you take note of that too, so you'll be ready when they make the call to you. Step number 3. Now, it is highly likely that the company you're with will call you. And they will do that probably within 2 months, 1 month of the end of your contract. And they will actually try to make some offers to you that are currently available to all customers. But they will make you believe that they are specially designed for you when this is not the case. So just be mindful of that too. And when they call, accept call recording. And when they call, you need to take your notes out and you will need to start negotiating with them. Now, what you need to bear in mind is that those that will call you at that moment are probably located elsewhere. So they're probably calling from a call center that has been hired by your company and that is probably located abroad in a country where the wages are lower. And this team that will contact you will have very little room for negotiation. So you can try to negotiate with them. But if you don't get what you plan to get, just leave it as that and wait till you get to the 4th step. Now, this step is very important. You need to wait until the last month on your contract. And when you get there, what you want to do is you want to go to the web page of the company you're with at the moment. And you want to find an offer that they have that is slightly different or slightly lower than the one you have. And you want to go on the web page and ask them to contact you. So you may do that via chat, or you may do that via a call me button. And when you do that, give them the phone number for which you have the contract with them, and or the one they have on record to contact you. And they will contact you. And when they do, now you need to bring out your bargaining skills and bring your papers out. Okay, the notes you have taken before, and start negotiating with them, seeing where you can reduce your bills and where maybe you can add some options that you don't have and keep the same amount rolling. And if they say that they can't do that, ask to speak with a supervisor, someone that will have room to negotiate with you for real. And when you get to that person, take note of the time and date and the name of the person you're talking with, and always accept recording of the phone call. So that will give you leverage, and that will be the proof of what you've established with them. And make sure that you negotiate with them and that you get what you were looking for. Once that's set, write that down and wait for the next step. Now, your new terms that you have negotiated will start on a date, and this date is likely the next bill that will be after the end of your previous contract. And when this bill comes, you really need to read through it carefully to make sure that what you've negotiated with them actually took place and that you're getting the benefits now. If that does not happen, well, that's maybe because they need to access your data and edit your contract. And that's someone with supervising credentials that need to do that and to access to your contract to modify it. So if that does not appear on your bill, you will need to call them again and make reference to all the notes you've taken, the person you've been talking with, what you negotiated, on what date, at what time, and they will access the recording and make things straight for you. And then when comes the next bill, when you can check it again and make sure everything comes right. So I really hope that will help you to lower your bills. This video is the first one in a series that I'm starting now to enable you to save on your e-bills. And in the next ones, we'll be looking at maybe how you can lower your software bills and other things. And if you want, please do subscribe and watch this next video. Bye-bye.